This short video explains the resources you will need in order to conduct a systematic review. Preparing to conduct a systematic review requires four elements: team collaboration, extensive searching, adherence to guidelines and standards set by various organizations to ensure transparency, reproducibility, and bias mitigation, and time. We will discuss each element in more detail. Team collaboration. You will need a minimum of two researchers to evaluate the studies for inclusion, and a third reviewer may be needed to serve as a tiebreaker. In some cases, a statistician may be needed for quantitative analyses. Extensive searching. In a systematic review, we aim to gather all empirical evidence available on the topic and to minimize publication and reporting bias. You will need to search multiple databases and evidence sources to collect all relevant information. This can involve searching multiple databases, such as PubMed and Embase, and evidence sources. A variety of search methods will be used, including citation searches, hand searches, cited reference searches, and errata searches. You will also need to search for unpublished, gray, and non-traditional research literature. Examples may include industry reports, government reports, and dissertations and theses. The third requirement of a systematic review is adherence to guidelines and standards set by various organizations to ensure transparency, reproducibility, and bias mitigation. There are a number of well-known organizations to which you will become familiar: Cochrane, National Academy of Medicine, formerly known as the Institute of Medicine, AHRQ, Joanna Briggs Institute, PRISMA, and others. Check out the guidelines by these organizations. You will find the link in the video description. The fourth requirement is time. An article in 2017 in BMJ found that 67.3 weeks is the average time for completion and publication of a systematic review. The predictor tool can help you estimate the time required for your project parameters. You will find the link in the video description. Before embarking on a systematic review, check your readiness with a couple of tools. First is this flowchart. What type of review is a good fit? The link is given in the video description. At the top of the flowchart, the first question is, how big is your team? If you are the only member, then you need to decide if you will have a robust methodology. If yes, consider a rapid review. If no, then a literature review is best. If your team is more than one, then consider the flowchart to the left. How much time do you have? If over 5 months, then you need to decide if your research question is specific, follow the left arrow, or broad, follow the right arrow and consider a scoping review. The left flow with a specific question can result in a systematic review. If you will be analyzing the results quantitatively, a systematic review and meta-analysis is a good fit. Another assessment tool to check your readiness is what review is right for you. It provides guidance and supporting materials on conducting knowledge syntheses and supporting the results. The link is in the video description. It's important to have adequate resources since there are significant risks with partial or under-resourced systematic reviews. All systematic reviews being considered for publication must be methodologically sound, non-redundant, and provide useful clinical information. Inadequate resources may harm the quality of the syntheses. Read this article for details on the risks. The link is in the video description. If you don't have sufficient resources to complete a systematic review, watch our next video to learn about alternative types of reviews you could prepare. And please note, there is a common misperception about systematic reviews. Sometimes people use the term systematic review when they really mean a literature review, which is a general summary and analysis of published research on a topic. Literature reviews require less extensive resources to prepare. In summary, remember that a systematic review needs a minimum of 2 researchers, extensive searching of multiple databases and unpublished literature, adherence to guidelines and standards, and much more time than expected.